Is your Nextcloud running slow, or do you want to unlock powerful new features? In this video, I'll show you how to supercharge your Nextcloud with those three essentials add-ons. Collabora for document editing, Redis for MySQL performance, and the high-performance backend for Nextcloud Talk. With these add-ons in your container setup, you'll get smoother collaboration, faster load times, and real-time communication without lag, all running in Docker containers with Nginx as a reverse proxy. I will show you how to set up each one of them step by step, and by the end of the video, your Nextcloud will be faster, more powerful, and ready for serious productivity. As always, you will find a download link with every command and every file we're using in this video. I'm sharing those with the Nextcloud we built in this video here. Okay, let's start with the first one. That's the Collabora server. With Collabora, you can create and edit spreadsheets, documents, presentations, all in your Nextcloud. And you can work in those files together with your team at the same time, just like in Google Docs or Microsoft 365. And to set it up, we're going to open up our Docker Compose file, vim docker-compose.yml. And in here at the bottom, we're going to add another service for the Collabora server. All right, I prepared that beforehand, but basically you just add another service here, Collabora, with the image Collabora code. The container name is Collabora and the host name as well, just to keep it organized. And as always, we set it to restart always unless it's stopped. And for the environment variables, we're going to set the domain to, in my case, Nginx server. That's the name, the host name of your container here. So it will know which Nextcloud it's allowed to serve. Then we're going to define a username and a password. Don't forget to set that in the .env file, just like in the other videos. And this one here, the extra parameters are for the SSL certification. And then as port, we're going to map the port 9980 to the container 9980. And for good measure, we are all going to put that in our Nextcloud network. So let's save this. And then we can start up our new container with docker-compose-up-d. And you can see it started the Collabora container. If we run it again, it will tell us that it's here. The Collabora container is running. With the new container running, we need to configure our Nginx reverse proxy. But before that, I would really appreciate a like and a comment and maybe subscribe. It really helps out small channels like me. I'm having videos planned for Docker for beginners and Nginx for beginners next, so stay tuned for that. But back to our reverse proxy. We're going to open a new terminal in here and switch to etc nginx sites available. And in here, we're going to create a new file. I always have one template, which is this one. Domain, and I will copy it to Collabora sysadminhub.com. And then in here, we're just going to change this one. We're going to set it to listen to the URL Collabora. sysadminhub.com. You just need to put in the URL that you're going to use. And in here, we're going to send it to localhost 9980. And for the Collabora server, we need something more. Let me paste this in here and make this pretty. But this one as well is in the file that you can download from the link in the description. And also we need to add this extra location. Let me just make this pretty one second. All right, just like this, now it's cleaned up. We just need to add this another location in here and also send it to localhost 9980. It's basically this cool location. Collabora needs this. So we can save this here. And then we need to create a symbolic link, just like always. We cd backwards into sites enabled. In here, we can create a symbolic link, ln-s. The location of the original file is in sites available. That's this one in here. And we're going to call the link the same one, then just paste it. And now we can test our Nginx configuration. Everything is okay. So we can say systemctl reload Nginx. And now all that's missing is a let's encrypt certificate. So certbot dash dash Nginx dash D, enter. It will request a certificate for this. Of course, you need to have a record set up in your DNS configurations wherever you're reserving your domains. And to actually use the Collabora, we need to go into the admin settings. You can see that? Yeah. Into the admin settings. And in here we go to office. And then we're going to change it to, we want to use our own server. And then we have our domain. And I don't need all this here. So we just save this. And now it says it's reachable. It's online with this domain that we set up. And down here at the bottom, you can configure whether you want to have OpenOffice format or if you want to use Microsoft extension. So for Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. So let's save this and we can go to files. And let's say we want to make a new file, a new spreadsheet. Collabora, we created. You can already see the extension is XLSX. That's from Microsoft Excel. And when you open it, you have your spreadsheets here. And you can even share this with other people from your Nextcloud or with someone else. And then you will be able to write stuff in here and work on that file together at the same time. All right, the next container that we're going to add as an add-on is the Redis container. As I said in my last video, we have here the databases used for transactional file locking, and we can even enhance the performance in here. In my last video, I said we're going to make an extra video for that. This is it. So back to the terminal. We will add a Redis container. What Redis does, instead of the Nextcloud always questioning the MySQL server, the Redis container will cache specific information and then it will load faster overall. For that, we're going to edit our Docker Compose file again. So change in here, and then in here, we're going to add another service just like that. As I said, you can download the file where this one is already finished in here, but basically what it is, it's the official Redis image. It uses Alpine, that's a distribution from Linux that's very small. And the container name and the host name, as always, we're going to set it to always restart. It needs to run this command with the Redis password that you're going to configure in your .env file. As Redis environment, we're going to pass through the password again. And it needs a volume, so Redis data. And don't forget to define the volume here on top or at the bottom, wherever you want. Doesn't really matter for Docker Compose. We can save this as well. And after that, we can run our Docker Compose up command again. I have an error in here. Let me just fix this. So what my error is, I have here Redis data YT, but in here it's all only called Redis data. So we're just going to add YT here, save this, and Docker Compose up. And now it's running. As you can see, there's our Redis running. And after that, there is one small change that we need to do. Let's open up another terminal and let's change into the volume. So var lib docker volume, the container name is Nextcloud. I think this one here. We have the data, and in here we have conf config. And in here, we're going to edit the config.php. In here, we're going to paste in this. Be careful when you copy this, because it will copy this one as well. And then it will think it's a comment, but it is not. Let's just make this pretty so it's easier to read. Actually, we can indent this. What this is, it's just telling Nextcloud to use Memcache and use Redis. And here's our container Redis with this port. We don't need to expose this port anywhere because we're only going to use it internally between those Docker containers. And then in here, we have the Redis password that I actually need to change or else it won't work. And then the timeout. The Redis password is the one from your .env file. Okay, let's save this in here. And then we don't need this terminal in here. And now let's restart everything. Docker compose down. And Docker compose up D. It will stop and remove every container and then start them up again. And now with the Redis container running and configured, we can run this command in here. It's going to tell us, okay, so the monitor is on. And now if we check something in our cloud that's going to use the Redis, the mail is not. But now you can see how it's running everything through the Redis container and improving and boosting our performance. All right, with Redis now working too, we can concentrate on the last part, the high performance backend for Talk. You can use video calls in Talk without the high performance backend, but as soon as you start to have multiple team players in there, it's going to get laggy because every user needs to send their video to everyone else. And with the high performance backend, that's just going to improve dramatically. And for that, we're going to add another service to our Docker compose file. Let me just paste it in here. And then let me make this pretty. Okay, this is much more readable. So what we have here is an image from Nextcloud, the all-in-one installation, but we're only going to use the high performance backend. We're giving it a name and restarting it always. We're going to define the turn ports 3478 TCP and UDP. You also need to configure them in your firewall for your Linux server, and also the port 8081 TCP for signaling inside the container. And as an environment, we're going to tell it which Nextcloud can use this high performance backend. Obviously, in my case, mine, in your case will be yours. Then which one is the talk host? We're going to define a turn secret, signal secret, and also an internal secret. And those one are really easy with just 6 commands. Okay, with this command, we can create random secrets. And also we can append them into our .env file. So another one for the signal secret, append this one as well, and our internal secret, which we need in our .env file too. So we can close this, we can save this, and then we can restart everything. Just run this again. And now you can see that our high performance backend is running. So now we need to configure our Nginx again. So we're going to cd into etc Nginx sites available. And here we create our signaling, the sysadminhub.com. But that file you can download. And then after that, we're going to create a symbolic link in sites enabled. So in here, we run ln-s. The original file is in sites available. It's called signaling. And we're going to call the link signaling as well. Mine is going to say file exists because I already have it. After that, we run nginx-t to test everything. Everything is okay, so we can run systemctl reload nginx. And after that, we need our SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt. So certbot --, nginx-t with our domain. Oops, but no underscores. This time we need real dots. It's going to tell me that I already have one, so I'm just going to renew this one. And now we have an SSL HTTPS certificate on this domain as well. With this up and running, we can go into our cloud to our admin settings. And in here we have talk, and then we can add a high performance backend server. In here it's HTTPS signaling dot sysadminhub.com. It's asking for my password. We confirm this, and in here we need our secret for the signaling server that you have in your .env file. I'm copying mine, paste this in here. It says here everything is running. So we go down here to our stun servers, and in here we're going to add a new stun server. It's cloud the sysadminhub.com with the port 3478. So stun settings saved, and I'm going to switch this one down here just so it will use my stun server first, and then after that the stun server from Nextcloud. And last but not least, we need to add a turn server, turn only. This one is also the same as the stun server, and we need our turn secret from our .env file, and it's using UDP and TCP. And in here you can test it, and the green tick says it's up and running. So if we go to our overview, it's not telling us anymore that we don't have a high performance backend server anymore. And now your Nextcloud is fully optimized with Collabora, Redis, and a high performance backend for Talk. If you don't have a Nextcloud yet but want to try one out, check the link down in the description. You can join my Nextcloud demo for free and register there. You can watch all my Nextcloud setup videos in this playlist right here, from basic setup to security and hardening and the performance boost. And as always, if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. I'll be happy to help. See you next time.